Since 1965, the state of Texas has been testing the blood of every newborn for potentially devastating genetic disorders. Today, all states in the U.S. require newborn screening. These blood tests are performed on blood specimens collected in the hospital after birth, and again in the office or clinic of the baby's healthcare provider at 1 to 2 weeks of age.
Many babies with these genetic disorders appear healthy when born. Finding them early can prevent serious illness, mental or physical disabilities, or early death. Each year, the newborn screening program gives hundreds of Texas children a chance for a relatively normal, healthy life.
The Texas Newborn Screening Panel includes nearly 30 disorders and hearing screening. Many of these rare disorders can cause irreparable damage in the first days of life. If a test result is suggestive of a disorder, prompt follow-up is critical. In some cases, changes in diet and/or other simple interventions can prevent lifelong consequences. In November of 2006, Jesse Neal was born in Marshall, Texas. Testing Jesse's blood samples, lab technicians detected a possible MCAD deficiency, a rare genetic disorder that, if left untreated, can cause sudden death.
It never even occurred to me that that test would save his life.
Just weeks before Jesse's newborn screening samples arrived at the Department of State Health Services laboratory, testing was done for just 7 genetic disorders. The day Jesse's blood samples came in was only the second day the state laboratory had begun reporting results for MCAD.
If he'd have been born a week or two earlier, I think they'd have missed him. And if they did not catch him, his levels were so high he'd have died.
But Jesse got a second chance, as do the approximately 700 infants in Texas who are diagnosed each year by confirmatory testing following an abnormal newborn screen. The screening specimens are obtained by pricking the heel of the newborn and placing 5 blood spots on a collection card made of special filter paper. The blood spot card must be sent to the state laboratory within 24 hours of collection for testing. If a newborn screen suggests a disorder, nursing staff with the Department of State Health Services Newborn Screening Program are alerted, and they immediately call the baby's healthcare provider to coordinate clinical care.
Early detection and treatment is very important for these disorders because it helps prevent lifelong disabilities and even death.
After the state laboratory has finished testing, the blood spots are stored safely and confidentially by the Texas Department of State Health Services.
The stored blood spots have beneficial public health uses once newborn screening is completed. The state laboratory may use some of the stored blood spots for quality assurance and quality control to maintain Clinical Laboratory Improvement Act or CLIA certification. This certification is required to perform newborn screening tests and ensure the validity of test results. CLIA requires such QA/QC activities. Stored samples may also be used to evaluate the newborn screening program, both for internal review and for comparison with other state programs. In addition, the stored blood samples have the potential to help improve newborn screening testing methods. The stored samples also have potential value for the child from whom they were collected. For instance, the child's medical provider may request additional testing on the remaining samples. You're only 24 hours old one time in your life, and your blood is very different at that time than at any other age.
In the long term, using the confidential and de-identified blood spots in medical research could help improve the health of all Texas children. Screening blood spots may be used in research to find new ways to diagnose and treat disorders and diseases. There are privacy safeguards in place for such research. Most importantly, unless the parents or legal guardians give advance written consent, researchers are not allowed access to any information that would link a particular blood spot to a particular child or the child's family. The Department of State Health Services does not allow release of blood spots or associated data for research uses by external entities unless that research has a public health purpose and certain controls are in place. Researcher projects involving the use of residual blood spots will require review by the Department of State Health Services Institutional Review Board, which is a body of scientific and legal experts charged with protecting the privacy rights of the persons from which the specimens came. This review board is governed by federal and state law, as well as agency policy, to ensure that the privacy of the individuals in question is protected. Only those public health-related research projects that are approved by agency management and the Institutional Review Board may go forward using residual blood spots and/or associated data, and those that go forward must adhere to the approved research protocol. The storage and use of blood spots after the screening takes place has been an issue in Texas in recent years, and in other states and internationally as well. Parents have voiced concerns about how a child's genetic information could be used in the future. Federal laws regarding the privacy of protected health information and use of genetic materials have been in place for many years. Changes to the newborn screening state law, as amended in House Bill 411, passed during the 82nd Texas legislative session in 2011, changed the process for residual specimen uses. Where parents could previously opt out of long-term storage and possible research uses of specimens outside of DSHS, parents and legal guardians must now opt in to allow specimens to be kept longer than 2 years and to be used for public health research. Effective June 1, 2012, parents and legal guardians will be presented with and asked to complete and return a new form titled Parental Decision for Storage and Use of Newborn Screening Blood Spot Cards. This form will be page 2 of the 2012 specimen collection kits. Providers must attach and give to parents page 1 and page 2 of the specimen collection kit at the time of each newborn screening collection. Page 1 provides parents information on newborn screening. Page 2 is a decision form that provides a means for the parent or legal guardian to decide if the blood spots may be stored after completion of the newborn screen and be used for research purposes outside of DSHS. Providers must verify that the form was given to the parents by checking the box located on the blood spot card. Parents may complete the form and return it to the provider or mail to DSHS at a later date. If the signed form is returned to the healthcare provider, it must be sent to the DSHS laboratory. Even though the parental decision process has changed as a result of the new law, providers should continue to use the 2010 and 2011 specimen collection kits through the expiration dates found on each kit. To determine the year of the newborn screening specimen collection kit you are using, check the serial number. When the kits approach the kit expiration date, providers should contact the DSHS Container Preparation Group at containerprepgroup@dshs.state.tx.us or 512-776-7661 for instructions. Providers using old kits, 2010 or 2011, should continue to distribute page 1, but should remove and discard page 2. Use and storage of screening blood spot cards, directive to destroy newborn screening blood spot card following testing. Finally, providers should distribute an 8.5 by 11 inch parental decision for storage and use of blood spot cards form with each specimen collected. These forms are available for download in English, Spanish, and Vietnamese at http://www.dshs.state.tx.us/lab/nbsbloodspots.shtm. The department is continually taking steps to ensure transparency about the use of the blood spots while emphasizing their importance in public health.
The Texas Department of State Health Services is committed to protecting the personal information of the children tested in the newborn screening program. If a child's blood spot is used for research, no personal information will accompany the child's blood spot unless it's approved in writing and in advance by the parent or legal guardian of the child. When research involves using a blood sample, only one spot is used for the research project. Another good quality blood spot is kept in case the family needs the spot, such as in the case of requesting additional medical testing.
If you have any questions about blood spots, call 1-512-776-7333 or toll free at 1-888-963-7111, extension 7333. Or visit our website, www.dshs.state.tx.us/lab/nbsbloodspots.shtm.